everybody. I just want to say this at the top, but please remember I am not a medical expert, so if you have questions about your own medical care, please make sure that you are asking your own personal doctor. Okay, thanks.
If you're going to be spending lots of time outside, you need to make sure you're prepared with all of the right equipment, even if you're only doing something as simple as a day hike. So today I wanted to show you how I build an outdoors first aid kit. I kind of lied in the intro. We're not going to build a first aid kit, we're going to deconstruct one. The first important piece of material you'll need in order to build an outdoors first aid kit is some sort of plastic or otherwise waterproof sealable container. I really like these plastic screw lid drink mix containers. They're small, they're hardy, they don't crush easily, and they do have the screw on lid to keep water out and other things out too, so this seems like a nice protective container for all of my first aid kit bits. And like I said, it's small, so this isn't going to take up very much space in my backpacking pack or even in a day pack. The first aid kit that we're going to be deconstructing today is my backpacking first aid kit, so it's got like everything I could possibly need in it. But if you don't want to build an outdoors first aid kit that's quite this thorough, you can look down here on the table and you'll see I've got a label for day hike essentials and also things that you would want to add to the first aid kit if you were going on a longer backpacking trip. So as I deconstruct my first aid kit, I'll be splitting things into those two groups so that you can decide what your first aid kit needs. Okay, so taking off the lid. Oh! We'll see what's inside. Came out like those snake things out of peanut butter jars. So the first few things that I have in here are some Band-Aids. So that's pretty simple. It's always nice to have a few Band-Aids around for whatever. Day trips, you never know when you're gonna get a little cut. So these are good for like fingers, hands, knees, whatever. So I'm definitely gonna put these Band-Aids go in day hike essentials because they're always useful. Next, I have a little Ziploc baggie of painkillers. So I took them out of the original plastic bottle because the plastic bottle would just take up space, especially when it's only got a few pills in it. It definitely wouldn't fit in here. But that just seems like extra material and extra weight to be carrying on a backpacking trip. So I put some painkillers in a little Ziploc baggie. These aren't really that important for just like a day hike because you can probably, if you're on a day hike, get somewhere quickly to get medication if you need. But on like a longer multi-day backpacking trip, if I got a headache or I like strained a muscle in my shoulder or something, it would be really nice to have these. So these will go on the long backpacking trip side of the table. Next, I have some Vaseline, like lip therapy stuff. This could kind of go either way, honestly. It could be good for a day hike, especially like in the winter. You can put chapstick type stuff on your lips and on your cheeks to prevent wind burn, especially when it's really cold out. But I wouldn't necessarily put this in a day hike first aid kit for the summertime or the spring when most people are going hiking. So I guess I'd probably put this closer to the long trip side of the table. Here are some more Band-Aids because you can never have enough Band-Aids. also because some of these are different sizes and shapes, so it's nice to have a lot of Band-Aids. Okay, then I have some Neosporin. So this is really cool. So this is like an antibiotic ointment that you would put on the bandage before you put it on the cut, and it helps keep germs out and prevent infection. I really like this because normally this kind of germ killer gel comes in like a tube, kind of like the lip stuff did, but these little individual packets, it does create trash, which kind of sucks, but I like this because it's flat and a little flexible, so it packs into this container really nicely. If you have Band-Aids, you might as well also have this stuff. So I will put the infection killer material over on the day hike side as well. Let's see what else we got in here. Okay. So the next things are kind of in a bundle together. So the thing that's creating the bundle, I'll show you first. So this is a long strip of just white cotton material. So this is, I don't even know if this is a triangle bandage or if it's just a rectangular bandage, but it's a really long bandage. So these are useful if you've got a little more backpacking first aid knowledge, maybe beyond the super basic first aid. So these bandages were something I added to my first aid kit after I took my wilderness first responder training. So this kind of bandage is good for actually like wrapping up if someone strained or broke their arm or their leg or something like that. So this is definitely a bit of more advanced material for when things really go wrong and you can't get to a hospital quickly and easily. So this definitely goes over on the long backpacking trip side of the table. Wrapped up inside that bandage was some cortisone cream and some more antibiotic ointment, like what was in the little packet that we just had. So I would maybe put this little packet in a first aid kit for a day hike with a few band-aids, but maybe this bigger tube would go in the backpacking trip side because, you know, more dangerous things could happen on a longer trip. I'm not saying that they will, but it's always nice to be prepared. That's why we're building a first aid kit in the first place. The other thing I have in here is cortisone cream. So this works with antihistamines. So like if you got really, really bad bug bites or like poison ivy or something like that, this could help with those rashes or those itchy spots. So again, this is something that's nice to have if you know you're not gonna be home for a few days. Good to go on the long trip side. Okay, so down here in the bottom, more band-aids because you literally can never have enough band-aids when you're going outside. And then I have some alcohol pads. So again, these are really nice because they're the little disposable packaged ones. Again, it's kind of not great to make trash, but they do fold up really nicely and become very compact. So these are just the little like foil or paper wrapped alcohol wipes and you rip it open. Again, I would put these in the day pack stuff because if you do get a cut or a scrape or something, it's nice to wash it out with the alcohol wipe first and then put on the Neosporin and then put on the bandages. So that can go over there. These are all sterile gauze pads. Again, wrapped in paper, individual, but a sterile gauze pad is not necessarily something that you need for like the little bumps and scrapes of a day hike. These are something that, again, are used on a more serious injury that would be more likely on a long trip. So I think I'll put them over on the long trip side of the table again. So we've got sterile gauze pads for packing bigger cuts. And then I also have a Ziploc baggie that has a few rubber gloves, and you can't see it because it's kind of like wrapped up in here, but also has one of those little plastic mouth shields for doing CPR. Rubber gloves and the face shield, you guessed it, that's for like when something has gone really super wrong. Again, don't try to give someone CPR if you haven't learned how, because there are a lot of ways to do it wrong, but I encourage everyone to go learn how to do CPR because it can be really helpful. So yeah, I have my CPR mask and then I have rubber gloves. Again, rubber gloves are mostly for like dealing with blood, but rubber gloves also have a bunch of other uses because they're plastic. They're at least semi-waterproof, so you could use them for a whole bunch of things while you're camping. So this pack will go in the long trip list. And that's the bottom of my container. I think if I really wanted or needed to, I could put some other things in here too, or depending on what kind of trip I was going on, I might swap out some of these materials for other things, really dependent on the sorts of situations I would expect to be encountering. But as you can see, what you need in order to go on a day hike is not a lot. This could fit very easily in like a plastic Ziploc bag or something like that. The materials that you would add to the day hike materials in order to pack a first aid kit for a longer backpacking or multi-day canoeing trip, this is a little more intensive, but again, all of the stuff on this table fit in this plastic drink mix container very snugly, and the plastic drink mix container itself fits very nicely in one of the pockets on the side of my backpacking pack. So this is really what I feel confident carrying with me when I go on trips. And you can see that some of these materials are a little old and I might actually want to renew them. I bet these alcohol pads specifically are dried out because they seem really old. But they seem really old because I haven't had a reason to use them, and that's great. I always carry the first aid kit with me because you never know when you're gonna need it, but most of the time you don't. Most of the time you don't need it, and that's great, but if you don't have it when you do need it, it's really not great. So I hope that sort of laying all of this out on the table and talking through it with you has been really super helpful. If you're going on any trips, especially multi-day long backpacking or canoeing or whatever trips, you should definitely pack a first aid kit. Go take a first aid class if you're able. Go take a CPR class if you're able, or renew your certification or your training if you did those things a while ago so that you're still in practice, because your health and safety while you're spending time outside is no joke, and I want all of you to be able to enjoy your time outside without having to worry about injuries or bug bites or poison ivy or whatever. So hopefully you thought this video was helpful. If you have any other questions about first aid kit building for backpacking, or if you have suggestions of things you like to have in your first aid kit, please feel free to put them in the comments down below. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it. If you didn't like this video, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support the Roving Naturalist, remember to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. Then go check out my Patreon page. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.